This game is called Jumping on the Lily Pads. The goal of this game is to roll a die and jump your game piece to the end of the board. In this case, we're jumping frogs on numbered lily pads to go swim in the pond at the end. This board game might seem simple, but it actually gives kids a lot of math skills to practice. While they play, they're recognizing written numerals, practicing one-to-one correspondence, learning number before and number after, and recognizing how many immediately without counting, a skill called subitizing. They're also learning how to play a board game with a number path. To play Jumping on the Lily Pads, we'll start with a 1 through 5 lily pad board. We'll use 2 frogs as our game pieces and 1 die. We're gonna start out with a die that has only 1 and 2 dots on it. You can make this type of die yourself by drawing dots on a cube. Eventually, we can play this game with higher number game boards and dice that have more dots on them. Kids love rolling dice and hopping frogs, but you can change the theme of this game to anything your child is interested in. It could be jumping on dinosaur prints or jumping on flowers with a butterfly or a bee, whatever topic is interesting to your child. You can also play this game on a number path that you make on the floor, or that you draw outside in chalk, and kids become the frogs hopping along. So here we have our little frog, and the frog is gonna start at home, where he lives, and the frog wants to hop all the way to the pond to go for a swim. When first playing this game, you can start by asking kids what they notice about the board. You can learn a lot by asking questions like, do they notice this is a 1 and this is a 2? And it's always great to give kids time to play around and get used to the game materials. Then when you're ready, roll the die. In this case, we have a die that only has 1s and 2s on it, because at first we really want to focus on those small numbers with kids. So I roll and I get a 2. And I'm starting at home and I'm going to jump 1, 2. And I'm going to count my jumps out loud. Then it's my partner's turn. And they roll and they get a 2. And get to jump 1, 2. When kids roll the die and recognize the number of dots they rolled, they are practicing a skill called subitizing. Subitizing is our ability to quickly recognize quantities. And kids get lots of practice subitizing in this game because when they roll, they really want to know immediately what number they got so they can move their frog. So keep rolling and hopping until you get to the pond, and kids can swim around with their frog in the pond. You can play that you need to land exactly on the pond, or that even with a roll greater than what you need, you still get to the pond. It's up to you. Feel free to change the rules or make up your own rules along the way. Then after the frogs swim around for a bit, you can roll to have them hop back home. And the hopping back is really great too, because children are seeing how the numbers go backward in order. And kids need lots and lots of practice with number order, both forward and backward on the number path. This game also helps kids understand that numbers are spaced equally apart. One thing that's really important in early math is the idea of number magnitude and comparing numbers, knowing that the 2 is 1 more hop than the 1, just like the 10 is 1 more hop than the 9. So once kids are comfortable hopping 1 to 5, you can move on to the 1 to 10 board. And here I have slightly smaller frogs than before because they'll fit better on my board. For this, you can continue with the 1 to 2 dice, or use 1 to 3 dice. Now, many kids will not yet have had experience playing board games, so they might not know that when I roll a 3, I move 1, 2, 3 spaces. And then when I roll a 1, I'm not going to go back to 1, I'm going to move 1 more to 4. Another thing that's tricky for a lot of children is sometimes they want to do their first jump on the number they're already on, instead of jumping forward. So you really want to emphasize that with each roll, the frog moves forward. And while you play, you can ask questions like, how many more hops will it take for us to get to the pond? Or, so what number do you want to roll? Do you want to roll a 1 or a 3? Why? And helping them see that a 3 would get them closer to the pond. Or you can ask, who do you think is going to get to the pond first? Who's further from the pond? Who's closer to the pond? Are we the same distance? How many more hops till we get to go for a swim? When children are ready, the next stage in this game is to practice counting on. Counting on is the idea that if you have, say, 5 plus 3, instead of starting at 1 and counting all the way up to 8, you start at 5 and count on from 5. So 6, 7, 8. Counting on is a skill that kids will use a lot in first and second grade because it's a skill that they use in addition. So say my frog is on 3, and my partner's frog is on 2, and I roll a 3. Instead of counting 1, 2, 3 hops, I'm going to say the number that I'm hopping on, in this case, 4, 5, 6. And studies have shown that this type of number path practice really improves kids' understanding of number magnitude, meaning how far apart the numbers are from each other. So my friend here rolls a 1, and instead of saying 1, she says 3, because she's hopping forward to that 3. And then I go again and get a 2, and I'm gonna say 7, 8. So as you can see, there's a lot of math happening when kids play jumping on the lily pads. And remember, you can practice all these same skills with life-size setups on the classroom floor or outside. And playing games with a friend or in a small group also fosters social and emotional skills like being patient, taking turns, and solving problems collaboratively. Games with an element of competition also give children an opportunity to practice winning and losing graciously and with respect. Check out our website for more games and lots of other ways to learn and practice math.